Add value to your identity. Be the person God designed you to be.
There.
And I I've always one thing I know already to me answer. Okay, yes. Mr. George, yes. Introduce yourself first of all.
Well, thank you, all our viewers. Please, we are here at Victory Gardens, and we are so thankful. We are so grateful. We are remarkably thankful for you for logging in and being with us. And we are here to inspire you, to encourage you, to lift you up. And we are here to engage with you. And I'm so happy to see all of you. God bless you. We love you.
And today's topic is an interesting topic. Mm-hmm. Building positive, remarkable relationship. Look at that. I also am keen to listen to this topic today. Mr. George, what is positive relationship? Let's start there.
Wow. Thank you, DJ Covenant. The reason why we came up with this very interesting topic, you know, building positive, extraordinary relationship is because as I mentor people, you know, I encounter a lot of people with issues. And I remember last week I was talking to a certain young man who was saying that he lost his job and he doesn't know what to do. And the guy was giving up, you know. And I said, how was your relationship with the employer? And of course he told me it was not good. How is your current relationship with your family? He says, it's not good. The wife left. Oh. Can you imagine? Then I asked him, how is your relationship with God? He told me, I don't know God. And I said, wait a minute. We need to teach people on how to build positive, extraordinary relationship with the family, with the friends, with God, with your employer. Because once you build this extraordinary relationship, this exceptional relationship, this amazing relationship, and it be positive, DJ Covenant, and our viewers, you can be able to conquer any mountain, including Mount Kenya, Mount Kilimanjaro. You can conquer the challenges because people are key in our relationship, whether it is the family, whether it is the workplace, whether it is government. When you talk about building positive, extraordinary relationship with government, they talk about loyalty. So, Muru Mutesia was loyal to Moi. And that loyalty is rewarded. The same with the employer. When you build a positive relationship with Optiven, for me, I can tell the loyal, we call them partners or the staff. I can see somebody who is loyal. I can tell. And when the reward comes, DJ Covenant, these are the first people to get rewarded.
There you go.
I am telling you because the relationship with Optiven or your employer is positive relationship. And you can't have positive relationship if you're the one who murmurs. You're the one who talk badly. Unajua sasa tunalipwa kanusu. Tunalipwa 40%. Warikata mshahara. You're always complaining. That's the recipe for chaos. And of course, when you talk about relationship in workplace or in family, you are talking about peace. DJ Covenant, if the relationship in your family is positive, once you enter that door, regardless where the house is small, whether it's a single room or a double room or a bed sitter, there is peace in the house because the relationship is right. DJ Covenant.
Yes. Wow, that's interesting. And I can feel the emphasis of a positive.
Positive, extraordinary relationship. It works. It has worked everywhere. The other day I was looking at the politics of America. I like the politics of America. And when these guys are choosing the deputy or the person to run us up, they look at the positive relationship. Somebody that can be able to support the big boss. And I can tell you, our viewers, if you only work on that, I can guarantee you the next 5 years, the next 10 years, you'll be a totally different person. Because fighters go nowhere. But the people who either support a vision, or they support their families, or they support their friends, you are there when your friends need you. I can tell you, you can go places. Yes.
Hey, Mr. George, this topic is going to be very interesting, and I'm very keen to listen to this. Mr. George, let's go back to our topic. How to build a positive relationship? How do we do that?
Wow, thank you for all our viewers, and we are here to share with you on how we can be able to build extraordinary, positive relationship in our lives, in our families, in our career, in our businesses, wherever we are, even in the platforms that we are in, either on WhatsApp on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, on Tumblr, on LinkedIn, all these platforms, we can be able to build a remarkable relationship. What you need to do is easy. I'll share with you six ways or six strategies on how to build this relationship. And the number one is simple: respecting one another. You know, respect is a big thing. And once you respect the people you live with, when I respect DJ Covenant, the way he is, I can tell you, relationship improves. Once you respect your spouse, relationship goes toward positive relationship. Once you respect your leader in the organization, your manager, where you report, don't say who you manage, haja sama kama mimi. No, respect them. Someone told me that the people who succeed in organizations, they are those people who make their bosses shine. Don't complain. Let your boss shine. Don't say, my boss give me a lot of work. No, do it. One day, you will also be served. People will be under you and they'll make you shine. That is how you can be able to build this extraordinary relationship by respecting one another. Number two, appreciating one another. You know, we are human beings. They say that once you are a human being, you need to be human enough. And once you are human enough, people believe in you. You know, humanity makes you believable. Humility makes you approachable. Humanity makes you believable. Humanity makes you approachable. You can be able to appreciate people with all the humbleness, and the people will approach you for advice. People will approach you for the needs that they have, because DJ Covenant, the globe today has got many needs. You know, I went to the village the other day, and I discovered that a lot of people are now in the villages because there are no jobs in the cities. They have retreated back to the counties. So once you appreciate these people the way they are, I can guarantee you the relationship will be positive. Number three, showing care for one another. Care for one another. Whether these people are able, whether these people are middle, whether these people are have-nots or haves. Care for each other. Your own children, care for them. Your own spouses, care for them. Those who are leading organizations, care for those people who work for your organization. That way, you build a positive relationship that can literally, DJ Covenant, move a mountain. Because positivity brings positive mindset. It brings abundance. And that way, we can be able to move to the next level, DJ Covenant.
Wow, great. Let's proceed on, Mr. George.
Wow. How to build extraordinary relationship.
Yes.
How to build amazing relationship. Number four, accept and celebrate other people regardless of their differences. Accept and celebrate other people regardless of their differences, all opinions. Many times we separate because of different opinions. But if you accept the way people are, if you accept people according to their tribes, you don't care which tribe they come from, but you celebrate them, I can tell you the relationship will keep building. It's unfortunate that Africa was subdivided into very small portions. Actually, Africa should be 8 or 9 countries. But we kept splitting. We kept splitting. As we split, relationship doesn't come very well. Of course, you have seen what is happening between Kenya and our neighbor here.
Yes.
Sometimes we are fighting. Sometimes we are together.
Yes.
Sometimes we are fighting. Why? Because we are not able to accept and celebrate each other. People will never be enough. Equal. People will never be equal. Countries will never be equal. Kenya cannot be like Djibouti.
Never.
We are bigger. Kenya cannot be like Rwanda. Our economy is bigger, 4 times bigger than Rwanda. But we need to accept that there's a small country called Rwanda, and we celebrate them. When you see good roads, although Rwanda is the size of Kajiado as a county, we celebrate them. The same with your life. Are there people that you miss relationship because you refuse to celebrate them? Maybe they are doing a wedding. Tell them congratulations. Like now my good friend called Deka. Naitwa Karanja.
Yes.
Deka Karanja.
Yes.
His wedding is tomorrow. An hour kesho. In the morning, I saw a post on my WhatsApp. I told him, Deka Karanja, now you have become a man. Congratulations. Go and develop positive, extraordinary relationship with your spouse. That's the only way we can be able to keep moving, enjoy life, and live better. Number five, be a listener. Listen actively, listen effectively. Be a person who listens. God gave us 2 years to listen. But many of us, even people who are watching us, you have no time to listen to other people. Develop the listening talent whereby listen to your children. Listen actively, not listening when your phone is when you're typing.
Yes.
Be there, listen. Show by movement that you are listening. Because today, the world is looking for listeners. People are not there to listen. People are there to talk, talk, and nobody is listening. Can you imagine, DJ Covenant? And once you become a listener, you understand people, and the relationship can only be better. Number six, give people your time. They say time is a scarce resource. But you need to give people your time. Personally, I've been running a project called, a program called School of Mentorship.
Yes.
Every Thursday, 3 to 4, we are there. Teaching and training people and coaching them how they can be the top salespeople, how can be the top marketers. And I'm so happy that we have tens of people who are running their own businesses and they're attending those classes. Why? When I teach about selling and marketing, I'm not teaching from a textbook, from Brian Tracy. Neither am I teaching from John Maxwell. I'm teaching from my 20 years experience in sales and marketing. So I can tell them, if you're managing your own business, this is what you need to do. So I create time for people. If you're there, if George can create time for people, if DJ Covenant is here, creating time for you, you can also create time for other people, because every person listening to us, you can be a mentor. You can mentor people. Go to your villages, mentor those people. Go to your families, mentor those people. Create time for people. Give people your time. I know it's not easy, but once you do that, you develop relationship. Number seven, DJ Covenant, our viewers.
Yes.
Learn to give and take feedback. Yani, learn to give feedback and take feedback. I like the people who work in the hotels.
Yes.
The feedback they get from customers. Unampelekea kama pale GMC, umepeleka kabuzi, na upepo imekuja kamepoa. The kind of attack they get. But it's a feedback. So learn to accept that feedback and also give feedback. So don't go to a restaurant, you go to Panarottis, you eat that giant pizza. I think it's called Monster Pizza.
Yes.
And then you have a feedback. Don't withhold that feedback. Give it to John Gogi. You go to Waterfront, not Waterfront, Eagle Peak Spa at the Hub Garden.
Yes.
Mahari kuna turibs, tunauzwa pale. Inaitwa Eagle Peak Spa.
Eagle Peak
Spa. Najua una miss kwenda pale kufanya FB show.
Yes.
Hey, unakumbuka?
Yes.
Ile shake tulipewa.
And you've mentioned two places.
I tell you.
We need to go back to those
Panarottis
places.
Panarottis and Eagle Peak Spa.
And yes.
Umeshapewa na Alec ribs. Umeuma. And you have feedback. Maybe the ribs were so sweet. And you are withholding feedback. No, give it. Tell Alex or Gaida, the ribs were amazing. You never know. You may create a relationship. You may create that feedback for people to have that energy. But as you give feedback, also learn how to receive negative feedback. Be like a politician. Me, I like politicians. Unawatukana leo. Kesho nakusalimia. That's a strategy.
Yes.
Unamuita asijui nini.
Yes.
Kesho anafanya nini? Anakusalimia.
Anakusalimia.
Let's learn how to take the negative
feedback.
Criticism. Yes.
Hey. Benefits of positive relationship.
Wow. Very interesting. We'll be very, very, you know, open that there are many benefits of a positive relationship. You know, the other day I was talking to somebody and who listens to us and says that since she started listening to our programs, her life has changed. She has become brighter. She has opened up. And this is as a result of relationship with us and our viewers.
Yes.
And this relationship encourages personal growth. That is point number one.
Yes.
Positive relationship encourages personal growth.
Wow.
You can be able to change your financial status. You can change your social status. Because hakuna mzee kama Kevin, anatafuta mtu amekaa kama guru.
Hakuna.
Anataka mtu wakufurahi, wakucheka-cheka.
Yes.
Flexible. Positive relationship. It encourages personal and social growth. Number two, you get support during tough times. If you're a person of who encourages positive relationship, life is made up of challenges. When you have challenges, you are able to get support, the yes. benefit of a positive relationship, mm-hmm. it adds meaning to life. Why should you be gloomy, Bwana? Why should you be so gloomy? You can be able to have that those positive relationship, remarkable relationship, mm-hmm. and you add value to your life, you know? Mm. Add value to your identity. Be the person God designed you to be. And then the last one. Mm. Positive relationship build trust. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm. If you are a person need a covenant, the person who care, mm-hmm. you build trust. Mm. People trust you. People come for solution. Mm-hmm. And then bonus point. This is very interesting. Mm. Reduces stress.
Mm.
Yeah.
And a release.
Yeah.
And a release.
Reducing stress. Yeah, mm-hmm. Kuna stress.
Wow.
Yes, DJ.
That's an interesting one. Mm.